These are balanced search trees, okay, designed to work well on magnetic disks or other direct access secondary storage devices. Okay. Bee trees are similar to red-black trees, but they are better at minimizing disk input-output operation. Many database systems use bee trees or variants of bee trees to store information. Now, just before knowing the exact properties, we should know how to create the bee tree. Now, so there is a parameter that is called minimum degree tree. So in a bee tree, if it is not a root, then t minus 1 number of minimum data should be there, and 2t minus 1 maximum data should be there. That is, if t is equal to 3, minimum 3 minus 1, 2 data should be there, or maximum 5 data should be there. Okay. Now, suppose we have a data, say 2, 9, 5. So 2, 9, 5, 4, 12, 13, 7, 8, 11, 17, 1, 3. So first data is 2. So let assume t is equal to 3. Okay. So that means here the node structure is like that. So maximum it can store 5 data. Okay. So first one is 2, so easily you can store 2 here. Then is 9, so we can store here 9. Then 5. Now 5 should be in between 2 and 9. Okay, so the content of the node will be like that. So content of the node, so we may start from here also, say first one is 2, then 9, then content of the node will be 2, 5, 9. Next is 4. So if it is 4, means 4 should be in between 2 and 5. Okay, so we can store 4 here. So 2, 4, 5, 9, 2, 4, 5, 9, 2, 4, 5, 9. Okay, for data, the next data is 12. So 12 should be after 9. Now we can store 12 here. Now the data is 13. Now if you want to store 13, so it cannot accommodate the data, because maximum data it can store 5. So identify the median value. So median value is 5. So break this value, break this node into two nodes, and 5 will be treated as a root node, content of the root node. So here should be the 5. So left part, the content will be 2 and 4, and the right part content will be 9 and 12. Okay, next is 7. Now it is a search tree, so 7 is what, more than 5 but less than 9, so the 7 should be before 9. Okay, now to accommodate 7, what we can do, so and after that, so 7 should be before 9, 7 should be somewhere here. Okay, and 8 should be somewhere in between. 8 is what, more than 5 but more than 7 but less than 9, so 8 should be somewhere in between 7 and 9. So if you insert 7 and 9 both, then the tree construction will be like that. The key construction will be, now 7 should be here, okay, 8 should be here, then 9, then 12. After that, 11 is there. So 11 is what, more than 5, more than 7, more than 8, more than 9 but less than 12. So 11 should be in between 9 and 12. Now in this case, the tree will be 11 should be in between 9 and 11, so we can put 11 here. Okay, now the data is 17, so we cannot, 17 is what, more than 5 and more than 12, but we cannot store here 17, so we have to identify the median value. So median value is 9, and move 9 here. Okay, you have to move this 9 here. So if you move 9 here, now the tree construction tree will be like that. So 5, 10, 9, okay, and so on. Here leaf content will be 4, then and the right content will be 7, 8, and so on here, and this here should be 11 and 12, and after that we can insert 17 here. Okay, we can put 17 here. Next is 1. So next 1 is there, 1 and 3. So 1 is what, less than 5, and it should be less than, so 1 should be before 2, and after that 3 is there, so 3 should be what, less than 5, 3 should be in between 2 and 4. So after inserting 1 and 3, the tree structure will be like that. One, two, three, four. Okay. After that, 5, in between 5 and 9, the content is what? 7 and 8. So 7 and 8. And after that, 9. After 9, the content is 11 and 12. Okay, so this is what, B tree. Now you can see different properties of B tree. A B tree is a rooted tree having the following properties. Every node X has the following fields. Suppose a node X is there. Suppose this is the node X. Okay, assume t is equal to 3, in x the number of keys currently stored in the data. Okay, so here how many data are there, 2 data are there, so in x, suppose it is x, so in x will be the, in x will be equal to 2, the in x keys themselves stored in non-decreasing order. So it is in increasing order, so 11, then 12, in this case 7 and 8, in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, it is all are in increasing order. Leaf x, a boolean value that is true if x is a leaf and false if x is an internode. There should be a variable leaf x. If it is true, then it is a leaf node. In this case, leaf x will be the false because it is internal node. Each internal node X also contain NX plus 1 pointers. Okay, now suppose it's internal node, and how many data are there? So 2 data are there, so NX is equal to 2, and the pointer should have the children. The children will be 3, so this will be the C1X, this will be the C2X, this will be the C3X. So this 3 is nothing but, this 3 is nothing but nx plus 1. Leaf nodes have no children, so their CI fields are undefined. So leaf nodes all are null. Clear? The keys KIX separate the range of the keys stored in each subtree. If KI is any key shorted in the subtree with root CIX, then Now these are the range. Suppose you want to know how many data are there in between 5 and 9, excluding 5 and 9, the data will be 7 and 8. Okay, or how many data are there before 5, more less than 5? How many data are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 data are there. So using B-tree, we can easily identify the range. All leaves have the same depth, which is tree's height. Now is a very interesting concept. All leaves are in a same depth. All leaves are in a same depth. There are lower and upper bound on the number of keys a node can contain. This bound can be expressed in terms of fixed integer t. T should be more than is equal to 2. Okay, called the minimum degree of the tree. Every node other than the root must have at least t minus 1 keys. Already we know. And every internal node other than the root that has at least t children. Okay, if it is not so, at least t children should be there. If the tree is non-empty, the root must have at least one key. Okay, so if it is a root, then there should minimum value should be one. Number of keys should be one. Every node can contain at most 2t minus 1 keys. At most 2t minus 1 keys. Therefore, an internal node can have at most 2t children. We say that a node is full if it contains exactly 2t minus 1 keys. Now here, 2t minus, if t is equal to 3, then 2t minus 1 is what, 5. Now how many data are there? Here 5 data are there. Now we can say it is full. Now if it is full, and if you want to insert a data, it is not possible to insert a data. So we have to split this particular tree. And more another interesting concept is there, say binary search tree, binary tree, heap tree, okay, AVL tree, all are constructed from left top to bottom. Okay, that tree height is increasing from top to bottom. Now here, if it is a B tree, the movement is from bottom to up, so the tree height will grow from bottom to up. Okay, next we'll see the B tree deletion. Okay, now obviously in B 35, 7, 20, 30, 50, 75, 1, 5, 9, 12, 15, 22, 23, 29, 32, 34, 37, 40, 42. Okay, this is the data. Now suppose you want to delete 9. Okay, so from this particular table, now assume t is equal to 3, so minimum number of data should be 2 and maximum data should be what, 5. So easily we can delete 9 because it satisfies the property. Now in this case, now after deletion of the 9, if you delete 9, the tree structure will be this. Now second is what, delete 30. Now suppose you want to delete 30 here, then the predecessor of 30, that is 29, is moved up. Okay, that means we have to move, if we have to delete 30, so we have to move 29 upward. So after that, the tree will be what? Now before deletion, the content of the tree is what, 35, 7, 20, 30, 50, 75. Now it is, here should be 1, 5, okay, 12, 15, then 22, 23, so 29 will be moved forward, 29, and after that it will be 32, 37, and the rest of the data. So rest of the data means what, 37, 42, 40, 42. So in this, the rest of the data. Now suppose you want to delete 20 here, so if you want to delete 20 here, so 20 is pushed down to make note. To make note 12, 15, 20, 22, 23, then delete 20. Means what? You just merge these two nodes. So if you merge this one, so you will be fine. Those 7, then 29, so 15, so 1, 5, then 12, 15, 20 should be there, 20, 20 should be here, 20, 22, 23, then delete 20 from this particular node. And the rest of the data, say 32, then here it is 34, not 37, 34, okay, 34, and the remaining the data part. Are you getting? Now suppose you want to delete 12 here from here, so we have to delete 12 from this. So before delete 12, we have to merge. Before delete 12, we have to merge this, okay, or you can see here we have to merge these three. So if you merge these three, so 7, 29, 35, 50, 75, this should be in a one, in a one node. 7, 29, 35, 50, 75 in a one node. Then 1, 5, 5, 12, the content will be what? You can see 12, 15, 22, 23. Now you can delete 12 from this. So if you delete 12, the remaining data will be what? 15, 22, 23. Now suppose if you want to delete 5 here, if you want to delete 5 here, if you want to delete this one, then 15 is moved up to fill 5's position. So you have to move 15 here, okay, and 7 is moved to fill 5th position. So 7 will move here and 15 will move upward. So after that, the data of the 1, 7, next.